Hi everyone, it's Vicky Papayannou here and I'm so excited to share a project today using the Birdhouses Through the Season release that I designed for Spellbinders. The release comes with different birdhouses, one for every season, and I will be playing today with a spring one, as well as a set that gives you lots of birdies in different positions and the brand, and I am going to play with that today as well. The birdhouse sets for every season come with a different shape of a birdhouse and then lots and lots of different elements that you can play with to embellish it. So for example here you get a circle window that you can place inside if you want to cut out a window. You get a nest which is designed with a slit so you can easily add elements inside such as the eggs or a little birdie or even flowers. And in your set, you will get both the eggs, the flowers, and the leaves. Another fun element is the fence that you can use if you like, and always keep in mind that all the elements on all the sets of the birdhouses are interchangeable since they have the same proportions. Now, when it gets to the set with the birdies, you will get six different designs of birds, all in different positions. Some of them are looking on the left, on the right, they are flying, so you can play around with them and create your little scenes. You'll also get a very realistic looking branch that you can use for placing on top your little birdies or even hanging your birdhouse. For today's card, I'm going to use the spring birdhouse. I will use a couple of birdies, and from the summer set, I'm going to grab the wooden plugs so that I can create a tee to place my birdhouse on top. I like to do as much die cutting as I can with one passing, that's why I'm going to bring in all the cardstock that I decided to work with, as well as the dies. So for the birdhouse, I'm going with the craft colored cardstock. I'm also placing that circle window inside, and I will cut out the wooden plugs out of the same craft cardstock as well. I'm also going to use green cardstock for the leaves, and I grabbed extra leaves from the spring set as well as from the bird set. I'm also going to cut out flowers out of that pink cardstock, a white fence, and yellow birdies. And now I can run all these dies through my die cutting machine. At one passing, I will end up having lots and lots of elements, pretty much the most of them that I need, and then I will run a couple more times the leaves and the flowers so that I can have more embellishments to decorate my house. And in the spring set you will get multiple flowers as well as multiple leaves, which is going to eliminate the time you spend die cutting. I'm gonna run the birds one more time out of lighter yellow cardstock as well as the house, because I want to have an extra roof. The birdhouse die not only cuts out the design, but it also embosses, and the easiest way to bring out that embossed detail is to ink up your cutout. Here I'm just using Distress Oxide ink and I'm going with a vintage photo. And I'm going to repeat the same process for the wooden plugs. These do have an embossed design as well, and these were designed to stick them together as a letter T so that you can use them with all the birdhouses in the collection to stand them on top. It is a great element if you want to create a slimline card because it is going to turn your design into looking longer. I'm going to leave that aside for now and I will come back to it later on. Now I will work on the roof. For the roof, I'm going to cut out the top from the red cardstock, and it is designed in such a way so that you can easily separate it. Then you can stick it on top of your main birdhouse either by using your glue or by using some foam tape at the back to make it pop a little bit if you want to. For my design today, I'm just going to stick it down with glue. For the tiny little details like the heart, I like to use a piece of double-sided tape at the back so this gets sticky at the front, and then I can easily pop inside all the rest of the elements. I'm also going to use some foam tape at the back. I will peel it off and then stick there a piece of scrap brown cardstock. This way I will have a bag on my house, and at the same time it is dimensional, so I can easily pop inside a little bird. Now let's go back to the letter T. This specific birdhouse does have a wooden plank at the bottom, so I'm just going to remove the one that I stuck previously. And I'm going to stick that directly underneath my house. Just make sure that you play around with the dies that you get. They give you so many different options and you can customize them for your needs. I also find using the fence super adorable, and for that I'm going to use tiny little foam squares at the back so that I can pop it on top of my house. By having that dimension on the fence, I do get the opportunity at the same time to have flowers and leaves tucked in between the fence. I'm also going to put the birds together. These are really simple to put together. When you cut out the main body, you will see that there are indentations, there are embossed details, and it tells you exactly where you're supposed to go stick the belly as well as the little wing. For the eyes, you can stick at the back some double-sided tape and then stick the eyes on top at the front, since it's going to be sticky, or you can just stick a black cardstock at the back and you are good to go. Now I'm working on the background where I'm going to create my little scene. This is a white cardstock and I'm going to ink it up mainly at the top, going for an ombre look here from blue all the way to white. For my ground, I'm simply going to use my scissors and cut out a couple of shapes that can be used on my ground to look like heels. It really doesn't get any simpler than that. I'm just auditioning all the pieces directly on my card base, and if I need to, I can do some adjustments. And then I'm going to ink it up just a little bit to give it more depth and so that it doesn't look so flat. Now all my elements are ready, it's time to put my card together. I'm going to stick down the little heels, and for the one of them I'm going with glue completely flat. For the other I'm using foam tape so that it is a little bit popped up. Now it's time to put my birdhouse in place, and I absolutely love how it looks even now, but let's embellish it even more to bring it more to life. So I'm putting one of my yellow birdies inside the house, and he's super cute, but I don't want him to be alone, so I'm going to give him a friend or family. I'm going to stick the other birdie at the top of the roof. And now finally it's just a matter of decorating the little birdhouse with leaves and flowers that you have cut out. You can add as much or as little as you like. You can play with different colors to get completely different looks. I decided to go with lots of flowers and leaves as if they were climbing all the way from the bottom to the top of the tree. It's a bright and happy design that can work for sending some birthday wishes on a spring birthday. You can use it for sending thank you or just saying hello. I am going with have an amazing day, which comes from the Tweet Sentiments stamp set from the same collection. I'm using my glue and I'm going to stick that on top of my standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And then finally I'm going to add some white dots at the center of all the flowers. There are cutouts that you can use instead if you wish so. I just went for more dimension. You can always embellish them with tiny little gems. Here is a close-up look on the card that I made for today, and I had so much fun die-cutting and putting all those different elements together to create a scene. And before I say goodbye, I'm going to share one more idea. Make the exact same house, but don't use the bottom. Instead, use the branch and hang it from there. This branch is included in the set with the birdies, and that branch along with the tea stand provide optional elements to create variations of the same design. Here are some close-up photos on today's fun spring card that I created while playing with products from the latest collection by Spellbinders called Birdhouses Through the Seasons. Thank you all so much for joining me today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired, and I hope you'll all have a lovely day.